back in the CSTR. You don't know how well mixed you are, boy. Back in the CS, back in the CS, back in the CSTR.
The continuous stir tank reactor, or CSTR, is often used to carry out liquid phase reactions. A specific industrial example would be a fermenter, which is used in biological processes in many industries, such as brewing, antibiotics, and waste treatment. CSTRs are operated continuously. An assumption about CSTR operations is that the reactor is perfectly mixed, which means that there is no time dependence or position dependence of the temperature, the concentration, or the reaction rate inside the CSTR. So the concentration and temperature is the same at every point inside the reactor. Therefore, the temperature and concentration in the exit stream are modeled as being the same as those within the reactor. In this experiment, the following reaction will be performed in a CSTR. There will be electrical conductivity present in the system due to the ions that form from the reactant, sodium hydroxide, and the product, sodium acetate. Initially, only sodium hydroxide contributes to the conductivity, but as the reaction proceeds, both sodium hydroxide and sodium acetate will contribute, which can give us a means of determining conversion. To do this, however, we must first calibrate the conductivity probe to relate the conductivity to the amounts of both species present. The conductivity of the system can then be related to concentration of each species. With concentration data of each species in the reaction over time, our objective is to determine the rate constant K by fitting the following equations to the experimental data. The steady state concentration of sodium hydroxide can then be obtained from the following equation.
I'll be discussing the approach and material section for this lab. Make sure to have DeLager Pro connected to the computer and to your conductivity probes. Also make sure to have an overflow tank with the overflow line connected to the tank on the bottom. Make sure to have your 10 milliliter aliquots that you will use to transfer 0.01 molarity solutions of sodium hydroxide, acetate, and ethyl acetate that you will be provided with. Also make sure to have your KD scientific pump ready. And you will make sure that you recognize your 80 milliliter syringes for ethyl acetate and sodium hydroxide, which are labeled accordingly. And make sure to have your vernier conductivity probes. Your conductivity probe should be calibrated with 0.01 molarity solution of sodium hydroxide and sodium acetate. For the first run of calibration, you should use the 10 milliliter aliquots to transfer 10 milliliters of solution to sodium hydroxide from sodium acetate for your first run. For the second run, the opposite should be done. The pump should be prepared by measuring the diameter and length of the special syringes for the ethyl acetate and sodium hydroxide. These numbers should be input into the pump with the pump setting set to 1.2 liters per minute. Make sure when you place the syringes in that they're placed in their stoppers, because if you don't, the pumps will keep continuing to push the syringe in and will destroy the glass. And use your vernier conductivity probes to measure these concentrations.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is now time for an important safety bulletin. First on our list is chemical safety. In this experiment, three chemicals will be utilized to initialize the experiment. Sodium hydroxide is caustic and will corrode organic tissue. Ethyl acetate is flammable and a skin irritant. Sodium acetate is also a skin irritant. To prevent against bodily contact, wear goggles and gloves. You'll be glad you did. Make sure to dispose of all chemicals and overflow in the waste bin under the fume hood after the experiment. The waste bin will be labeled as the CSTR experiment. Next up on our list is equipment safety. You must exercise caution with the syringes. Use both hands and never set on the table. It will start rolling and break before you know it. The plunger and barrel are soulmates. Don't separate them. use the sodium hydroxide barrel with the sodium hydroxide plunger. Don't mismatch them. It can be quite damaging to the equipment. Thanks for your consideration, and enjoy the laugh!